Hello my dear students, welcome again for the online classes. Today we will continue with the same lesson of geography, that is lesson number 4, air. Now the today's topic is air pressure. Now children, you will be surprised to know that we are continuously under the air pressure. How? So how? We feel air but we cannot see air. Children, you know when we are standing, continuously we are under the air pressure. Air is continuously pressing us but we don't feel. Why? Because the pressure inside our body is equal to the pressure which force comes on us. The pressure, the air pressure and the inside body pressure are equally supporting each other, that we don't feel the pressure which is on us. Our body is continuously under the air pressure but we don't feel. We don't feel. So because children, we don't fall down or we are walking properly, we are able to walk up on the earth surface. Why? Because the inside pressure of our body supports to the pressure outside our body. Now children, let us see what is air pressure. Air pressure is defined as the pressure exerted by the weight of air on the earth surface. Means children, really it is very difficult to say that the air pressure, we are continuously under the air pressure but still we are normally walking, we are doing our activities and all the things regularly. Why? Because inside our body also there are some pressure because of which we are not getting disturbed by the outside air pressure. Now children, see here, the air pressure is highest at the sea level and decreases with the height. Now children, in class 5th we have studied about the altitude. What is altitude? The height of a place above the sea level is called the altitude. Now children, suppose this is sea level, this is our earth surface. Now we see different elevations on the earth surface. Now when we are at the sea level, the place which is above the sea level, here the air pressure, here the air pressure is highest at the sea level. But as we move above the earth surface, as we move at the higher places, and it decreases, the air pressure decreases with the height. This means what? The air pressure is highest at the sea level and as we move above the earth surface, the air pressure decreases. Now this we will see from, as we go up, the air pressure comes down. Now children, horizontally, the distribution of the air pressure is influenced by the temperature. Now how? How by the temperature? How the temperature affects the air pressure on the air pressure in the atmosphere? Let us see. When the air is heated, it expands. Now how? How the when the air is heated? Now children, see here. I will explain you how. Now this is our earth surface. When the sun rays falls on the earth, the air, the earth surface gets heated, and as the air gets heated, it becomes lighter and it moves upwards. It moves upwards. So children, see, as the air is heated, it expands. When the sun rays falls on the earth surface, the air is heated and it expands and it goes up because it becomes. So here low pressure is created. Here we have the low pressure. Now children, these are the clouds, and when the areas which are the cold air, when the cold air comes on the earth surface, it is creating high pressure. Okay, now direct sun rays, and so there the climate is hot and humid, and so there is the places near the equator have the low pressure because the air gets heated and it expands and it moves towards the up, it goes up, and the places which are at the cooler places, there we can see the clear skies and the we can see the skies very clearly. Why? Because these are the areas where we have the high pressure. Now children, now see here. Now when this wind blows, when this air is at a high pressure, and when this gets up, this high pressure air moves towards the low pressure because here a hollow space is created. Yes or no, children? And so we say that the air moves from high pressure to low pressure. And so children, it is said that when the air is heated, it expands, it becomes lighter and goes up. And cold air is denser. The cold air is denser and heavy, and it tends to sink down, creating high pressure. The cold air is dense and thick, heavy, denser and heavy. So it remains here, creating high pressure. And when this air goes up, the hollow space is created, and this cold, it moves here. And so it is said that the winds blow, air blows from high pressure to low pressure. So children, this way the air distribution of the air pressure is influenced by the temperature. So children, this way the air pressure in the atmosphere affects the climatic condition. So today I have covered the point air pressure. So read the concept thoroughly and